Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses for us certain things. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who gives, and He is the one who can prevent someone from receiving. So everything is from Allah. When Allah gave prophethood, He chose those whom He intended to give prophethood very carefully, with the best amongst them being Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we need to know that from among the people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had chosen them to go through test upon test. If you think that you have had issues in your life, or you have had problems or difficulty or calamity or hardship in your life, you need to simply go through the lives of those whom Allah chose being higher than you and I in rank. And those are the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon them. Remember, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the prophets of Allah are the ones who are tested the most. And after that, those who are closest to them, and then those who are closer, and so on. So if you're having a lot of challenges, but you're a believer, trust me, it's a good sign. إِنَّ اللَّهَ إِذَا أَحَبَّ عَبْدًا ابْتَلَاهُ. When Allah loves His slave, He tests him. It's supposed to bring you closer to Allah. It's supposed to bring you closer in a way that your heart is softened. You become a better person. You become more conscious of your obligations. And you become a person who knows, subhanallah, that I'm supposed to be abstaining from sin. And wherever I falter, I should be seeking the forgiveness of Allah, with hope in the mercy of Allah. This evening we read verses where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us of the dua of Zakariya alayhi salam. He did not have male offspring, and he wanted male offspring. He was quite advanced in age, and he made a dua. رَبِّ هَبْ لِي مِنْ لَدُنْكَ ذُرِّيَّةً طَيِّبًا. Now, many of us sometimes, we are married and we don't have children. And a long time passes and we start thinking to ourselves that perhaps Allah is upset with me. I'm calling out to Allah, but He's not answering me. That type of thinking is not supposed to be coming from a believer. We should know when Allah has decreed something, it is the best for us. What's the point of having children who will be disobedient to Allah? What's the point of having children who will create a disaster for you in your life by being the biggest embarrassment? What's the point of having children who will quit the deen and who might fight you as a parent, yet you made so much dua to have those children? So Allah knows what is better for you, and He knows